me, and they yelled at me because I wasn't reporting on time. Okay, give me some water. All right. So I was watching some videos from last week. As a matter of fact, we got it right here. And I'll just share my screen and we could do a quick review before we do a salute. Sorry.
Coming in and coming out.
Okay.
Coming in and coming out.
Right. Okay. So what are we on? We're on Bugsay. Okay. I want to do that.
I love how you got closer with your footwork. You know. Okay. Let's keep going. We're gonna watch you.
Okay.
Take a quick 1 minute break. We're gonna watch Mateo for a second.
Okay. There's another.
I would like you to make some observations.
Sorry. So we're going to go to elbows today a little bit more. There is something that I'd like us to watch together and watch later here. We're talking about, okay. We're going to just observe some elbow movements. Okay. Okay, this one. Actually, it's this one. Actually, it's, sorry, I'm skipping through. I'm trying to find the one about, okay, maybe that's not the one. Okay, all right. I'm gonna look for that video and I'll show you, but basically what we've been doing is the high elbow, right? And the elbow is what we're gonna be using a little bit more and utilizing it on our work. Okay, so I'll share that later. I'm gonna look for it. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. After today, we're gonna work focus on our slips and the 6 o'clock and the 12 o'clock elbows. And then after that, we're gonna bring back the Bugsay and we're gonna work on our hand switching with our hands. Oh, okay, Mike's gonna join us. Okay, so we're gonna dedicate some quick moments. We're gonna do a quick salute. All right, keep the mics in the house. Thanks for being here, keep the mic. And thank you for being here, everybody.
We're just gonna serve today.
We have some, thank you again. Salute.
Hello.
Hi, Lola. Okay.
Say hi to
you. All right, are there any questions before we begin? From last week? No, okay.
No, okay.
We're gonna do some quick warm-ups of the ball. First, two minutes is gonna be dedicated to defensive movements. We're gonna do slips, and we're gonna do dodges and parries. Okay, using your footwork, right? No contact yet. Pointing with your shoulders and your elbows, right? No contact. Doing slips, parries, and using the number 4 footwork and pivoting, right? You got 2 minutes. Let's go. Okay. No contact for now, Drayon. So this time you're going to let the ball swing, no contact, and then you're going to slip and dodge. If everybody just watch Patricia, everybody eyes on Patricia, please. Pierre, Dimitri, and Drayon. So look at Patricia, okay? Slipping through it, okay? You don't have to stay there at 6 o'clock. You can always move around, okay? Yeah, use your footwork to get around. Use your elbows to dodge, okay? Let's do that. Back to work. No contact yet. No contact. No contact. Always all slipping moves, dodge, dips, right? Come at it from 6 o'clock, from 3 o'clock, from 9 o'clock, from 10, 12 o'clock. Okay. Nice, Dimitri. Remember to guard your chin. Always protect your chin. 20 seconds. Okay, so here's your add-on. Now, double elbows, 6 o'clock and 12 o'clock. Now, the way you're going to execute, 1, 2, okay? 1, 2. Now, what you're seeing is a small microcircular movement that I'm doing. See this? Okay, so now you're going to go at it two times, right? Now, these elbows could represent uppercuts, right? So an upward elbow could be like an uppercut, but for now, we're gonna do elbows. So the way we're doing this is we're gonna release two strikes at the ball, okay? 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. We're gonna go 1, 2. 1, 2. Now, this inside elbow, this 6 o'clock elbow, when it's going down, it's weird. Okay? You have to really tuck it in. Okay, these are your power short. Okay, 2 minutes, let's go. Nice, Trish. You're like a blade. Yeah. The more circular that those elbows are, the quicker they'll be. Wow, you're like, wow, Trisha, okay. Nice, Drayon. Make it fluid, guys. Don't make it choppy. Make those double elbows fluid. It's easy to do a double upward elbow, but one elbow up and the same elbow going down. Remember, these elbows are defensive movements. They're also offensive movements, right? Nice, Dimitri. Remember, don't make your those big swim moves. Make these moves tiny and fine and short. Right? You don't want to be telegraphic. You don't want to show a big movement. You'll be telegraphed. And if it comes from the center, the faster and the quicker it is. It's harder to see if it's coming from the center. So try to make that 6 o'clock elbow, when it goes downwards, make that really fine and thin. Excellent, guys. You guys are looking amazing. Okay, here's your new challenge. Here's your new add-on. See if you can hit it 3 to 4 times, meaning the pendulum in, twice maybe, pendulum out, another once or twice, okay? Now, the faster you get, the more sloppy it'll start to look. So I don't want sloppy, I want really refined, and if you need to go slow, that's fine. And even if that means you can't get off 4 strikes at one pendulum swing, even if that means you only get 2 and then the other 2 from this next pendulum swing, okay? So 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, right? I'm traveling with it. I'm not just staying outside of the cordon range. I'm actually going into the cuerdas range, right? I'm going in with it. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, right? You can execute 4 all the time, but when you can execute 4, execute 4. Now 1, 2, and then run up to it. 1, 2, okay? You're doing, it's a lot, but sometimes you gotta like storm on something. You gotta storm on an opponent. So see if you do 2 to 4 elbows in 1 pendulum swing, no contact.
Back contact.
2, 1, 2. Okay, I'm gonna do it again. 1, 2, 1, 2. Step out. Now step out of the center line. If you find yourself step out of the center line right with the before the ball comes, okay? 1, 2, 1, 2, step out of the center line. All right? 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh shit, I hit it. 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay. So now some folks don't have the privilege of the space, and I totally understand if you don't have the space. But if you do have the space, this is where you're gonna be charging at the ball. You're chasing the ball a little bit. Okay? But try to have no contact yet, so you're maintaining your range still, okay? Now, you don't have to get 4 strikes all the time. If you could do 1 pendulum out of like 3 or 4 where you're getting 4 strikes, dope, okay? But I want, nice, Trish, wow. But yeah, I want you guys to be sharp, okay? Don't be sloppy. I really want you to focus on the pendulum ball, okay? 2 minutes, go. Nice, Pierre. Nice, Drayon. Yeah, remember for the elbows down, thumbs down. Yeah, thumbs down for the elbows down. Nice, Pierre. Nice. Small circle. Yeah. Position yourself, Trish, right? When you're striking, don't square up on it, right? Don't square up on it. Position yourself so you're angled. Boom.
Yeah, it's going circular, so I'm trying to figure out why.
I'm sorry. Hold on 1 second, okay? I'm turning off the music. Go ahead.
Oh, it was going in a circular way, so I was like, what's going on?
Oh, yeah.
When so I was like, I can't blade if it's...
Yeah, you're right. Nice. Excellent. Okay, everybody take a look at Pierre. Keep going, Pierre. Everybody take a break. We're gonna look at Pierre's screen. Pierre, keep going, please. So look, with Pierre, like in order for him to execute 2 to 3 elbows, it's really small, right? So small circles, and look how he's staying out of the center line after he comes in. Boom, he steps out of the center line. Because even if you execute the strike, if this dude you're striking is like either inhibited or they're high off something, they're gonna keep going. So make sure you step out of the center line after your strike, right? 1, 2, 1, 2, right? He's getting all 4, 1, 2, and then he steps in, 1, 2, right? 1, 2, he steps in, 1, right? He got 3 there. That's fine. As long as you step out of the center line so the ball doesn't hit you, right? Nice. Pierre, you got hit in the chin right there, bro. Excellent. Okay, back to work. That's what we want. I want small circular elbows, okay? Oh, actually, come take a look at my screen right quick. So just a reminder. So Pierre, thank you so much. Relax. So remember, your elbows is coming up, right? We also have these elbows, but we're not bringing those out right now. Right now, we're bringing the 6 and the 12 o'clock elbows. They're going upwards, right? And then they're going downwards. Now the downward, you see how I'm kind of like, I keep telling you guys, put the thumb down, right? The thumb down follows the elbow, right? And you see, remember, we want this towards the center. We don't want this swimming out here. It's easy to see, right? So we want these elbows to be less, we don't want it to be seen as much, huh? And more elusive. So that's why I'm putting my thumb down and I'm putting my hand to the center and I'm going to the center instead of going like elbow out here. I'm going to the center, right? And then it forces me to align my elbow with the center, which forces me, my other shoulder, to align with the angle. Boom. And then now it's going down. Okay, so this hand, remember what we learned from Maxwell the other week was he'll put his hands together, right? So if you, so I put my hands here and then I make the box. See this? I'm starting to make the box. Boom. Okay, so and then from here, I can go back with the 12 o'clock. Look, from here, I snake in, right? Right now. What Pierre was doing was he's executing smaller circles. So you won't, when you're doing it, you could do like a big circle, but it's gonna slow you down. But it's good because it's really clean, right? It's not like, hey, look at the big wide elbow. You want the elbow to come from the center, okay? Cool. Now, so now in order to execute the multiple elbows, then you make the circle smaller. Boom, boom. Right, and you can even do the reverse going upward, this one, right? Right, and then stepping out of the center line, because by that time you already, it's already committed to its full pendulum swing. Now it's going to start going backwards. So by that time, you want to step out of the center line, right? So you don't get punched. So you go 1, 2, 1, 2, step out of the center line. Okay? Everybody get that? Are there any questions? Excellent. Let's get back on it, and then we'll break out the weapons. All right? Here's some experimental folks for the folks that are starting to become advanced. But remember, work on alignment. Okay, you're not really advanced if you're not working on this alignment. But aside from the 4, right, start making contact with it. Now start making a little contact. Block three of them. Make contact with the 4th one. Or play around with it. Make contact with the 2nd one and then evade the other 2. All right? But always protecting your head. Always hands up by your head or by your chin. Okay? Let's go. Music up. Let me know if you have questions. And then we're breaking out weapons. Nice, Drayon. Nice. Nice. Out of the center line, Drayon. Excellent. Now, always your footwork should follow that too, Drayon. Feel free to V-step or sidestep out of the. So I want you to imagine that the ball reached all the way to the ground. So when it swings, that entire angle that it's taken on, that's the whole entire center line. So I want you guys to imagine that the ball is all the way down to the floor. So even your footwork is out of the center line. Because it's cool that your head's out of the center line if he punches you. But what if this guy is hella big and he's also kicking you after the punch? That means your feet is in the way of the center line. That means you might have evaded his punches, but he could probably still kick you or run over your foot. So excellent, Drayon. I can't see your feet, but just by seeing you move that way and you took a bigger V-step, I could tell you got out of the full center line. And that's what I want. I want folks to be fully out of the center line. Now, it's good to be your head out of the center line, right? Especially when it's a strike. But if you really want to blade your body, if you really want to embody the bladed, being bladed, then your footwork must also be out of the center line, okay? Also out of the center line. All right, now I'm gonna ask you to engage your first points, your fists, your hands, along with your elbows, okay? We haven't done our shoulder exercises, but we're gonna do long, then we're gonna go to shoulders. So now your fists as well, right? And remember, between a short punch versus a long punch, okay? Long punch is when you're fully extended your arms, okay? Experiment with facing your fists, your knuckles at 12 o'clock or at 6 o'clock. Yes, yes, Pierre. Right? I'm going to forward you on Instagram this Cuban boxing coach that I follow, and he does a really good breakdown of long punches versus short punches. Right? I want you to identify. We already know that your elbows are the shorter one. Right? But I also want you to identify your long punch, okay? Next, excellent. Now engage that with your evading, engage that with your slips, and then now you're starting to play around with combos, right? Blocks, strikes, slide some elbows in there. Nice, Drayon, looking good. Dimitri, you're killing your ball. Nice. Okay, I want everybody except Drayon, keep going. Everybody watch Drayon's screen for a second, please. Drayon is one of my former high school students. He's also a martial artist. He's boxing, learning how to box, and I appreciate him being here with us today. So let's observe him right quick. So what I like about Drayon's movement is he's really defining a clear when he's long range and when he's short range from it. And then he's learning how to evade fully. Like his footwork is out of the center line right there. Like not only his head, but his whole footwork. That's, and you see how kind of like fluid, and he was like looking like a water when he moves his, because he's distributing his weight evenly. I was working with him earlier, distributing his weight between his forefoot and his heel instead of dropping the weight. So you guys are all doing that. That's great. Now he's moving around at it at 3 o'clock, at 6 o'clock, right? But really taking, really being mindful of his angulation and his clarity of out of being out of the center line. Excellent job, Drayon. Keep up the good work. I like the footwork with the evasion. Okay, let's get back to work. Let's keep working on that. Good job, Drayon. Welcome, Mateo. Thanks for being here today. Mateo, we're working on elbows. We were working on evasion. Now we're starting to make contact. We started off last week with double elbows, 6 o'clock and 12 o'clock, making sure they're smaller circles and aligning it at the center. If you look at Trish is also combining, they started combining their long range, their fists, right? Also punching, but aligning your fist with 6 o'clock or 12 o'clock, really accentuating the largo, the long range. All right, doing a great job. Let's keep it up. And then promise we're going to do weapons. Sorry. But I want to do shoulders again because everybody's getting cleaner. I can see when people do it in their homework, huh? Mateo looking good. Now, you don't have to make contact all the time, right? But you can still, like, you can still work on your accuracy. Just because you're not making contact doesn't mean you're not really hitting it, right? Target the center of the ball with your center knuckle or with the center of your elbow, okay? Move fluidly, more dynamic, like water. That way you can recycle your energy and you're faster, right? Don't worry about dumping all your weight. Don't worry about extending all your power and your all your energy at the ball. We can work on that later. Right now we're working on fluidity, accuracy, and learning the rhythm and the movement of the pendulum ball. Excellent, Pierre. Looking clean as always. Keep it up. Awesome, Mateo. Nice. Mateo, you look like you're doing some math right there, bro. I like it. Elbows and shoulders are always aligned with the ball. Beautiful. Nice. Chasing the ball. Excellent. Excellent. Switching stances, 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock. Remember, you could always be far away from the ball, but you could always get closer to the ball, take more risks, right? Nice, Dreon, excellent, beautiful. Dimitri, excellent, Dimitri. Dimitri, play with the long range a little bit more, excellent, right? And more slips and evasions. All right. Now, if you could strike the ball twice with the same arm with 2 points, either an elbow and a fist, right, in one pendulum swing, that's just an extra icing on the cake. You don't have to. That's for those that want to challenge themselves and go a little extra. All right, now we're going to reverse, and we're going to bring in the shoulders. I want to try to remind you to keep your hands to yourself on this exercise, on this drill, right? And this time, we're going to focus on blocking. No, let me rephrase that. We're going to focus on evading and deflecting is the word, okay? Because you can't really block with your shoulder. You can break your shoulder. But if you ever watched Mayweather fight and the way he used the Philly shuffle or the way he uses his shoulder to deflect punches, and that way he's already cocked back to punch back right away, which makes him a great defensive fighter. So for us as Filipino martial artists, the way we translate that is looking at the shoulders. How do we evade? How do we use the shoulders to evade, deflect the center line, okay? So you never want to attack the center line because if they're bigger than you, and you attack the center line, then you might hurt your shoulder. Now, your elbow is different. Your elbow is a little stronger. Your fist is a tiny bit stronger, but your knuckles can still break, right? Your shoulder will definitely break if you're not training it and you just randomly tackle somebody. You got to train your shoulder to hit things. Okay, but for now, we're not going to hit things. We're going to deflect things. You see how I push it after or right after the edge of it, right? I always have a hand up to guard my chin. If my right shoulder is on the ball, my left hand is guarding my chin. If my left shoulder is aimed at the ball, my right hand is guarding my chin, okay? Now, when it's going on, when I'm feeling the center line and I'm letting it organically go, then I step out of center line and I follow it with my shoulder. Now, once in a while, I can want you to make contact with it, deflect it, or hit it, but not all the time. I want you to dip, slide, and once in a while, touch it. Touch it. Touch it. That represents somebody punching you, and then you're using your shoulder to deflect it. Okay? You could deflect it to your left or to your right. Okay? Now, this is different from a tackle, when you're tackling him. That's going to look slightly different, but similar in concept. Okay? Nice, Dimitri. Okay, point with your shoulders. Use it like a gun sight. Okay, because once you start pointing your shoulders, your elbows comes right after, and then your fists come right after. Feel free to switch footwork so it's not the same shoulder. Beautiful, Trish. Beautiful, Pierre. Feel free to chase it, attack it at six. Okay, now I want you to slip one, hit one. Slip one, hit one. And always hand the hand up. Remember, if your right shoulder is at the front, left hand's by your chin. Okay, always protecting your head, always protecting your chin. Okay, now, 2 minutes, I want you to start with the shoulder, engage with the elbow, okay? And then the last minute, start with the shoulder, engage with the elbow, close it out with a fist, okay? So shoulder and elbow. Now you're learning how to use all of your folding hinges. Your fists is not your only weapon. You have many weapons. Two minutes. And then we're going to go for our breaking out our sticks. Think about questions you might have for me. Nice, Pierre. Nice, Dimitri. Remember, when you're hitting it with the shoulder, always the other hand gotta be up. Okay, scissors. 45 seconds. All right, last minute. This minute, I'd like you to let it go around your head, right? So when you slip, having this beam going, letting it go around, right? Just adding this on, slip, go around. Slip and go around. Now with the footwork, you can do that now. But what I want you to do is this. When it goes around you, obviously no one got eyes in the back of your head. So what you're doing is you're working on anticipation, right? But when it goes around you, I want you to align your other shoulder and point it at it. All right. So look, it's going to go around, right? I go around and then my right shoulder. Okay. Now, if it hits you in the back of the head, that's a automatic punch, right? That's a you getting hit in the head. Trish, your effect is so dramatic with the wind. I love it. The way it looked.
It's super windy here.
Yeah, it's windy. And then your hair was going with it. I was like, bruh, we're going to make a commercial. Nice. As soon as it goes around you, Drayon, align your other shoulder with it. Right? Yes, yes. Align your other shoulder with it. Anticipate it. Nice, Mateo. Excellent. Now you can use footwork if you need to. Mateo, keep going. Everybody take a quick break. Eyes on Mateo, please. Okay, we're gonna watch Mateo right quick. Speaker view, but not Drayon's speaker. Pin video. Okay, so if we look at Mateo right quick, I love it because he's like just flowing with it. And even though there's not a lot of pressure on that ball, he's still stepping in. And as soon as he steps in, his other shoulder's aligned, right? His other shoulder's aligned. Now, no one got eyes in the back of their head. So what we're doing really is working on our anticipation and our timing, right? Excellent. Beautiful job with his shoulders. He looked like he's dancing. I love it. That's how Mayweather won all of those fights, man. You don't see him blocking because he's using his shoulder at the very end, at the very flush of it. Thank you, Mateo. Great work. All right. Go ahead and grab your stick. Get some water. All right, Maxwell. Kuya Maxwell is joining us. Kuya Maxwell, welcome. Welcome, Kuya Maxwell. We're switching over to weaponry now. I asked folks to go get some water and grab their stick. So if you have your weapon, get that ready. All right. Any questions regarding the footwork and the handwork and the movement regarding the pendulum on how you should behave with the pendulum ball? You don't have to strike it all the time. You can deflect it, you can guide it, you can evade it. You don't have to be succumbed to its pressure. You could control it, right? As long as you're working on your accuracy, as long as you're working on moving with it, okay? Not necessarily how hard and how strong you hit the ball. That's not gonna impress me. It's really how accurate you hit it, how precise you are, and also how much you control your power. Because everybody could exhaust their power, but how you control it. And then one of the things I look for the most is how you move with the pendulum, right? Because this is our movement that really, really counts, all right? Now you're gonna put it all together because you got a weapon. All right, everybody got a single stick, grab that. Ideally, a manual, because we're gonna continue to work on our Bugsay. Drayon, a Bugsay is the weapon in our system, in our Filipino martial arts system, that breaks down a long stick in three different ranges. Just like what you're doing with your shoulder, your elbow, and your fists, what we're doing that is with our weapons. We're learning how to see this weapon. And the stick that I brought you yesterday, the stick that you're holding, that's more like a medium to a corto stick. The Bugsay is really for the largo, okay? The largo stick is the longer. The longer stick, maybe like this size, but we're not, some of us are training indoors, so we don't have that privilege. So we're going to be using the medio size stick, but we're going to imagine it to be the largo. Okay. Now the largo or the Bugsay is a medium size stick. We've been utilizing it, using short range when we're this close to it, but every time we're using it with two hands, right? And we're not just squared up with it. We're actually taking it in angles. V-stepping with it, okay? And then we're always inserting one side and having the other side with us. The base is with us by our hips or by our shoulders, okay? Now you can do it with the other hand too. We're also striking it using what we call the fisherman style, when we're using it like this straight on. And you've probably seen the video of my surgery where you're striking and then you're extracting it. You're extracting it. So I want everybody to warm up doing that. While you're warming up with your strikes, I'm going to keep explaining it. That way for somebody like Jayon or Tito Mike that's in the room and observing, they understand what the fisherman strike is, okay? So for the rest of you that have already done this, go ahead and strike. So what we're doing, Jayon, is we're utilizing a pretend long stick into a medium stick, and we're grabbing it at the base like this, all right? And we're always holding it like this or like this. So similar to a single stick, right? What we're doing earlier, but now this is called the corto range, which is the closed range. Now, from the single stick, we're moving in closer, okay? So the two angles, are the two angles I explained before in the first class is strike one and strike two, the letter X that you're forming in front of you, okay? So the way we do that with your basic one, you go strike one, remember, and then strike two. But with this one, we're gonna go strike one. See how we're holding it two hands? And there's a leverage here. Okay? So the way you get that leverage is like this. You do follow the same angle, strike one, and then strike two is here. Okay? So once again, so from here, from neutral, right? You're gonna V-step. V-step and strike one. You can both be palm down, or you can do baseball style, where one palm is up and one palm is down, right? Same angle as strike one, right? Same angle. Remember, strike one is like this, and then strike two is like this. So for strike one, it's like this, right? But now you're holding it with two hands, okay? That's the medium range. Same for this angle. Right. I'm going to show you guys switching hands later. So now this is both palm down. Okay. And palm up. Now these two strikes is going upward. Okay. This first two strikes is going downward, letter X. Maybe we should stick on that. And the other two, letter X going upwards like this. But let's stick with this one. Okay. So get in front of your ball. Okay. Actually, before you do that, let's do the corto version. The corto version is short range. The short, this one, and then this one. So what you're going to do is in front of your ball, boom, boom. You can do both palm down, and then you can experiment with one palm down, one palm up, but that means you're switching, and we'll talk about switching later. All right, where are you guys at, the rest of you guys? Okay, now, for the next 2 minutes, I want you to work on the corto range, okay? Making contact, but also evading and blocking. Moving around with it, right? We'll go 2 minutes that way, okay? Nice, Mateo. Remember your hand switching. If you're hand switching, remember, one hand switches while the other one's holding the stick to minimize dropping your sticks, right? And then remember the two ideas, the concepts around being tight and locked around the stick, but also being loose at the same time, so you can be more dynamic with switching it between medium and short, and eventually long. Who's it? Have a long space right now. Okay, looking beautiful.
Sorry.
Let me know if you guys have questions. Nice.
Yes, I have one question.
Yeah, keep it that. Yep, just like that. It doesn't have to be too wide, Drayon. You can just have it like close, like this range. Yeah? Feel free to observe Maxwell. You can watch Maxwell and you can watch Patricia, right? Watch those two screens. Right? So still attacking with this short range, right? You see how they're guiding at the ball? Yeah. Yeah. So you could adjust your footwork or you could be stationary. Or you can go like this, V-step. Right? Or you could just body angulation. Right? Okay. Now for those that want, that can, you're going to insert the medium strike. Now you're doing short range, the corto, the medium strike. So from here, let's take a quick break and let's just watch my screen for a minute. Okay. So, and let me know if there's any questions, right? Okay. So this is our corto range. When you're holding the ball, when you're holding your stick at that range, okay? Now both palms down or one palm up and one palm down. Later when you're advanced, you can experiment with having both palms up. But right now I want you to focus on one palm up, palm down, or both palm down, okay? So that's the strike one and strike two. And then the lower one, strike seven and strike nine, okay? So on the ball, these could be strikes, and or these could be defensive moves. Okay. The other, for some of you guys who's that's been doing this, we're also doing this cross. Right. Now this is a little bit more challenging, right? And you don't want to accidentally hit yourself and hook yourself, right? So this is about having your range, your boxing square, and going with the angle, okay? Okay, now, you're doing that, right? Remember, you're locked right here, and this is on top of your stick, but it's loose. That way, you can move the stick between close range or medium range, and medium range is from close range, medium range, right? And you see how my hand is moving like I'm rowing a boat, okay? So here, look at my switch between the double palm down, right? And then I do a palm up, look, I go like this, boom. And then I go medium size this way, right? Even here, as soon as I pull here, I'm gonna do double palm down, right? Because my palm is already down, so I can go medium here. But if I want to go palm up from here, I'll switch here, okay? And then I go there, right? Now, the idea, I'm super exaggerating because I want you to see it, but it should be subtle. It should be like boom, boom, right? So now when I'm striking medium, so remember this is close and this is medium. So I have to step out a little bit more, right? So now, right, I'm extracting it. I'm striking, I'm extracting. So Drea, what we did last week was when we extracted, you kept it up here, okay? And then boom, and then extract, okay? All right, so let's do once and include medium strikes with your corto strikes, and then I'll put some challenges for you, okay? Trish, I know you had struggles with 7 and 9 last week. So let me know how that's working out for you. And Mateo, I know you mentioned certain things was uncomfortable. Let me know what you're working on or what if you have any questions about something. Okay. Otherwise, I'm gonna start doing some more add-ons to this because I know you guys have been building up the scale right here. All right, let's do another minute, 2 minutes on this. All right, here's your first challenge. After it comes at you, I want you to deflect it, right? After you deflect it, I want you to do an abinico, an umbrella strike, right? So deflect it with the butt, going to your left or to your right. Open it up. As soon as it opens up, it widens out. Hit it with the tip when you open up with this strike with abinico. From here, let's do that first. Let's do that first. Okay, and then I'll add on. Okay, so boom, boom. Subtle. So that's a jam. They coming after you, jam them. After you jam them, after they pull back, you open up with the umbrella to their right temple. Right? That's coming to their right temple. Now, if you could hit it with a tip, even better. That means you might have to back up. Nice, Drayon. So that's more like a circular, that follow-up strike is more like a circular strike. Nice, Mateo. Make it more circular, like coming from 12 o'clock to 6 o'clock. After you jam it. Nice, bro. And that's starting to experiment with short range to medium to even largo range. Excellent. All right, we're gonna do a next add-on. Jam. Okay, after you jam and you do the abinico, right? I want you to, Mateo, I want you to, boom. Right, so it's gonna, you're gonna go jam. And then from there, you're gonna let it circulate all the way. Yeah, so it's gonna look like this, slow motion. You're gonna go jam, tip. Medium, okay? You're gonna do jam, after you jam, you hit it with the tip, with this one, and that looks circular, right? That looks circular, like this. Boom, and then from there, here. Okay, so in real time, this is what it looks like in real time. Okay, boom, boom, boom. Now, accuracy is hitting it three times. Okay, go slow. Just do it. If you can't do it at real time, I'm okay with you hitting it super Tai Chi. Work on that first because that's how I started. Okay, I ended up doing it in two pendulums instead of the first only one pendulum. I would do it in like the, I'll even do it in three pendulums. I go, but when it comes back, then I do long a binico. And it comes back again, then I hit it with a medium strike. Okay. Take your time on this, because this is combining a really short movement and two long movements, and those two long movements look slow. It looks slow. That jam is quick. That one is quick, but that second one and that third one, they look slow. But what you want to do is also aim with your shoulder, so you can power that third strike. That one, Trish. It's a powerful strike. Yes. Dramatic with all that wind, Patricia. I love it.
I had to take down a lantern. It's too much. It's entangling.
Nice. I love that, Dimitri. Dimitri is doing like a small micro movement with his footwork that I want you guys to do. So it's really, yeah. Yeah, Drayon, it's like, boom, right? Boom, 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 boom. The third one is like slow, right? It's like, that's like your power punch. But that first two is quick. Boom, and then, yeah, because it's like you jam, and then it's a flick.
Boom.
Okay. Okay. Cool. The third one is slow because it's you're letting it circular.
It's the footwork for me.
Pulling your entire body at it.
So,
right.
So what's the footwork?
The first
for?
Two is gonna be is a quick or quick. Boom.
What? Do I hold it like this, or do I end like this?
So the first one could be a block, right? The first one's deflecting. The second one is you're sneaking in a strike, right? You sneak in a strike after the first one, you block them, and then you snuck one in. The third one could be a block too. Okay, now we're going to start a fourth strike in this combination. Okay, here's your fourth strike. You're going to go, Dimitri, let me show you right quick. So you did three, right? You're doing three. You're going, right? Here's the center line, here's your opponent, right? You jam or you deflect. And then you strike with that one, okay? Jam, then you strike. Jam, strike. And then you go, jam, you strike, and then you hit with this. Now this could be another block. They're coming at you with another strike.
Oh, okay.
So you jam, you strike, they're coming at you with another strike, you block. Now, from here, this is what I want you to do. You're gonna steal the range. You're gonna go and grab your stick here and then exit out. And strike with a number two. Okay?
Oh.
So you go one, two, three, four. And you see how I slide out of the center line? I go 45 degree angle when I release my hold. Boom. I step out with a number four strike, with a number four footwork. I go like this. Boom. And I step out. And then when I feel the range, I step outwards. I'm leaving the scene, right? I strike and I umbrella up. I protect my head. Okay? So you're coming in and you're leaving at a 45 degree angle away from the ball from your fourth on your third, after your third strike. Boom, boom, boom. Now, my third strike, I move out already. I do the number four footwork. I insert that for my third strike. Boom. And then for my fourth strike, you know, instead of like climbing up, I just go here and I cut out. Okay. Oh. Can y'all want to try that out?
Yeah. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Yeah, that fourth one is kind of challenging. Because what we're doing is you're switching. Yeah, nice one, Mateo. You're switching hands, right? One. Two. Right? Three. Four. Right?
Oh.
So I guess what I'm doing is after I do the three, I bring it back. I bring it back here. After I bring it back, this hand is the one that strikes. Right. So what we're doing, guys, is we're switching hands, right? We're learning how to like strike, defense, and then move away and switch hands on our way out. Now, it's a little much, you know, but it's just a good progression to what you're doing. So you don't have to feel like you strike the person and that's it. No, I want you to be able to learn how to step out of the situation. You stepped in, you guys chunked them up, and now I want you to learn how to get out. Right, and part of you how to getting out is you striking on your way out, right? So after that third one, boom, 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 right? Eagle is getting in the way, I can't see my footwork. Right?
Slow. Take it slow.
Okay, we'll observe for 2 minutes. And but if it gets too complicated, what you could do is just focus on the first one or two or three strikes. You know what I mean? What you're just doing with a four strike really is exiting out and you're switching hands. It's fancy. It's fancy smashy type BS. You don't need it, right? What I'm trying to get you to is I'm trying to get you to learn how to strike while stepping out.
So right? when you throw
you're utilizing it. What's that, Draymond?
When you throw the third hit, right? Do your feet land like this?
I love that you're doing this, by the way. Can everybody take a break? And I would like to, let's field this question together with Drayon since he's moved his camera to the floor, which I appreciate. Go ahead, Dre.
So, boom. Then it's boom, right? Then the third one goes like this.
Uh-huh. You're doing it in your with your right hand, with your left hand, right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I was doing it with my opposite. Hold on a second, okay? Let me just... I'm going to give you a big screen. Okay, so go again from the beginning, please.
So,
you're doing it with the other side, but that works too, as long as you're stepping outwards, right? You're not stepping towards the center line. I love how you're stepping outwards, not towards the ball, right? So, yes, that works. However, for the particular technique that I'm doing, you can take a look at me now. Good job by asking that question. So what I'm doing is, right, the ball is coming at me, right? So I'm jamming it with my left leg is in the front, right? My left hand and left leg is in the front. So I go jam, right? Jam. Now I could step out of the center line, obviously, I wish I should.
Yeah.
I should probably do that. What I'll do is this. Okay, so I'll do.
Yeah.
Step out, right? I'm V-stepping. And then as I V-step, I'll turn, right? Like a parry. So from there, I'll deflect. Okay. As the ball turns that way, as it exits out, then with my same left hand that I block with, I'm firing the abanico, which is like a circular flick of the wrist. It's more like a flick of the wrist, right? Boom. I'm flicking the wrist and I hit it like that. Okay? From there, this footwork is still the same in terms of I go like this. Now in real time, it might not be the same, right? Because I'm going to go boom, boom. So what I'm really doing is I'm stepping out like this. I'm stepping out, right? Boom, boom. Stepping out for this one.
Oh, okay.
Right? So this one. So then it's complicated. I didn't show you guys all the footwork. Then I step like this. Now I'm going to get out of the way of this one. And I'm switching hands. I'm going from here.
Oh.
Right? So honestly, it doesn't matter which foot is which. Does it feel comfortable? And are you out of the center line?
Yeah.
Right? And the most important part is you're stepping out of the center line. Because my footwork is not going to be the same all the time, right? Boom, 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 boom.
Right? Oh.
So as long as you're stepping out of the center line when you do the final strike, okay? So thank you. That was it. Let me know if you have any other – I don't know if that covered your question, actually.
But, yeah, it does.
Okay.
Now I know where street to lead with.
Yeah, and not you're not in your – and the most important part, too, Jayon and everybody else, is not being in the center line. That you're executing all your techniques while you're stepping away and not being in the center line. I think that's the most important part, right? So wherever the ball is going, just follow it organically, and as long as your feet's not in the center line.
Okay. Can you walk us through the step 3 foot and upper body transition again? Because I was doing the same thing as Drion. I was starting with my right side rather than my left.
Okay, yeah, and again, y'all, you don't have to be married to it. And I'm just using it as my particular movement and technique, right? And then you can use your own as long as it feels comfortable. But what I'm doing is I'm going 1, 2, right? So 1 and 2, I'm kind of in the same type of footwork. or maybe I'm adjusting a micro movement, right? Because I'm going from here and I'm slightly chasing the ball, right? So I'm going boom, boom. From here, I'm letting the ball, the stick circulate, then I'm striking like this, right? When this, I do the model footwork. It's what we call this model footwork, that every time we strike, we have this cross step, the number four involved, okay? Now, once you strike with this one, see how strong structure that is, right? Boom, then I'm stepping out while I'm grabbing the other side of my stick, I'm stepping out. So when I strike, it'll be on my right hand now. The weapon will be on my right hand because I switched it, right? So that's the footwork. I'm going one, two, three, four. Again, one, two, three, four. I'm going this angle now. I go one, two, three, four. Now, sometimes three might, the footwork might not be able to do it. I'll probably go one, two, three. Well, same thing. Three, four. One, two, three. One, two, three. The number three is where I'm, number three is where I'm stiffening and I'm sticking out the cross step back there. Right? I'm going one, two, three. So on three, guys, check this out. On three, when I do this strike, right? Look at my back leg, right? Like my stick and the tip of my stick and my ankle or my heel is pressed and is pointed at the same direction, at the same target, right? So I'm going one, two, look, three, four, right? So when you insert the number three strike, insert the number three footwork, right? Now we're doing this with weapons, but you can also do it with open hand, right? Boom, 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 boom. So that's another part of our martial arts system, is where we have that footwork, okay?
This one.
Yeah, and it feels, it looks weird, but if you structure yourself, look, my elbow, my shoulder, my elbow, the tip of my stick, the back of my heel, they're all pointed at the ball, okay? So that's probably a good homework exercise to do, is maybe doing this exercise, look. One side and the other side at home. Do this homework. Now, this is gonna start introducing the Largo, the Moro and the Largo footwork, which is wasn't my plan today, but I'm glad actually it came. This is actually when you're being, so by inserting that footwork, guys, that's what's gonna separate us from a lot of other Filipino martial arts systems, is because we have this, we include that more intentionally. And that starts making our circular movement starts to happen. Our spiraling, our spinning happens when we insert. And we showed this in episode one, the Mono variations. Now, never ever do we encourage, or we want you or any of my students to ever turn around, turn there and spin around when there's someone with a blade coming at them, okay? Never. But what it does is it's just training me to start learning how to align, right? That if I did have to do some, if I had to get away where I had to do some spiraling and spinning moves, then this is a good way to train myself. So every time I strike, my heel is pointed at my, it's the same angle that I'm attacking. Now, we're not covering that in class today. It just kind of organically came up, and I just wanted to bring it up, okay? But if, because I wasn't planning to go to the nitty-gritty of the footwork, I just wanted you to learn how to move around the ball at the time, okay? But since you asked. Excellent. We're about to wrap up. Thank you so much, guys. Keep going. I'm going to play some music. Let's go another 5-6 minutes, and then we'll do some reflections, and then I'm going to let you go, okay? Thank you so much for spending time with me today. Keep going now. Then I'll give you some add-ups, okay? Let's do 2 minutes. 2 minute timer is on. Let me know if you have any questions. Okay. Nice, Patricia. Okay, remember you're learning how to close the range between short, medium, and then extending later on once we have the chance to do largo. We haven't done largo yet, which is the long range, right? We did it with our open, but we didn't do it with our weapon because some of us got limited space. But the idea is important that we're at least familiarizing ourselves of how to continue to identify the ranges.
Can you please do a quick check of what I'm doing? I can't do it with a ball yet, but at least the movements.
Hold on 1 second, Trish. I'm going to just make you a big screen right quick. Say that again. What were you saying? Oh, you're muted again. Muted.
I still can't do it with the ball, but I wanted to check if the movements are correct. So
okay. Please.
Left leg forward. Corto strike here. Corto strike here. Largo over here. A circle step more walk than two. Got it?
Okay, so yes, the first one is good, right?
Two.
Hold on, Jonathan is coming in.
Here.
Jonathan's coming in at 11:20. So that one right there, so go back to your third one.
Okay, so one, two.
Yep.
Circling as I'm going in with a power strike here.
Yep, yep, that's it.
That's my thing. So one, two, so step back, step back.
Yep. Now remember.
I've been here.
Yeah, no, from there, right? You're gonna just step. You're gonna step up. Yeah. So after you, right? Can you see me? Okay. After you do that, right? And sit lower. Sit lower. Then you step outwards. You step out away from the ball. Right? Because what you're doing, you're doing this, and then you're striking from the same footwork. You can, but you don't have, what I want you to do is step out and switch. Right? Now, if you want to stay in the same footwork, you can. You can even do this. Right? Oh, you can do this, Trish, look. Right? That's if you want to stay in the same footwork. So that's totally okay with me. I like that. Guys, this is one of my techniques. You don't have to do this. You want you to do your own, just like what Trisha's experimenting with.
Okay? Oh, no. I want to do yours. That's why I need to pick.
Oh, that's dope. So if you want to do yours, so to add on to yours, right? To add on to yours, from there, if you don't want to move your footwork, look, a lot of those strikes. Going boom. Strike it as you turn out. And then on the way back. Right now, if you want to do what I'm doing, as soon as I did this, I said boom, and I stepped that way. I stepped out. All I did was I stepped away. Right, stepped away and switched my hand. And then what I did, Trish, was this. Look, this is some micro stuff. As soon as I hit it right here, this is what I did with my hand. As soon as I did this, I did this. I pulled it up, right, and then from here, I fold from it. Right. Okay.
Super nice. Super nice.
Cool.
All right. I want you, the last two minutes, I want you to come up with your own combination, ladies and gentlemen. And I love you for you to show us, memorize a 3-4 combination, adjusting to the range of the corto, medio, largo, or the short and medium. I forgot we're not doing long, right? And I want you to freestyle, but if there's something that you like, I'm like, yeah, I like this, memorize it. And at the reflection sharing, I'd like you to share it, okay? Excellent. 2 minutes, last 2 minutes. Have fun. Queen Jonathan joined us. Thank you, Queen Jonathan, for being here. Excellent. You, if you want to keep training, you're more training. I just want to, you know, check out with them, but you're more welcome to stay. I'm glad you're here, brother. Excellent. All right, let's go and freestyle. What we're doing, Queen Jonathan, is learning how to switch between the corto, medium, and long range, which you've kind of done already, but just experiment with playing around with the range and inserting what you were doing last, what you've been doing, and inserting this footwork. Okay, have fun. See you in a few.
So can I go neutral when I do this one?
What about it?
Can I land in neutral, like my footwork?
You can, yeah. But remember, sync, right? Yeah. But remember, Dre, you're transitioning, right? So after you sit on neutral, then you want to get your feet moving right away, right? Then you either do a cross footwork like this, right? Oh, right. Basically, keep your feet moving even if you land in neutral. Yeah, once you land in neutral, just keep moving, right? Keep the pendulum of the ball. Now, hit the ball with the tip of your hand. Damn, Mateo, I love what you're doing, bro. What were you doing right there? You were hitting it with like all sides of your sticks. And slide the jam and Benico strike when you can, okay? Because that's gonna be the quick one. Jam them in the eyes or deflect them and then insert the medium range. And making those range switch and doing it quickly and efficiently, right? If you make a range switch, but you're dropping your stick or you're fumbling, then that's not gonna be useful, right? Don't switch sticks, don't switch hands. Stick with one hand, defend yourself. But if you are gonna experiment with switching hands, make sure that you're doing it efficiently. Right, and you're giving your opponent a short taste and a medium taste. Excellent, you guys are looking beautiful. Our 2 minutes are up. I'd like to give you another 2 minutes. And then we're closing out for real, for real. And then for both folks that came later, if they want to continue to train, I'm gonna go for another till 12, but I wanna just make sure we honor everybody's time and close them out at 12:30, 11:30. If they wanna stay for reflection. Excellent, Dimitri, beautiful movement. Staying out of the center line, controlling the center line. It's okay to cross the center line. Just make sure you're not in the way. Excellent, Pierre, beautiful. I'm gonna go around the room. Last 1.5 minutes. Excellent, Trish. I know you're in a small spot, but maybe experiment with stepping out like a half an inch or a step when you deploy your middle medium strikes. Yeah, step out, step backwards. That way you can still work on your accuracy. Excellent, beautiful. Dimitri, you're like lightning quick. And with clean footwork, may I add, thank you very much. That's what I want to see. Oh, I love that. I love that cross block. Beautiful. Excellent. Now, all of these strikes doesn't have to be offense. A lot of these strikes could be defense, you know? Excellent, Pierre. Oh, Pierre, the way you're balancing that energy of the ball, that's the next level that we want everybody to get on. Because now that's talking about leverage. Huh? So keep working on that, because we're going to bring that up to class the next month or so. I love that. Beautiful. Hey, I'm not bad for your first day of class with me, bro. That accuracy, okay? When you're making touch, I want you to touch it with the tip of your stick, okay? Accuracy over power, accuracy over speed. Later, we can work on power and speed. Oh, man, Queer Jonathan, beautiful movement. Oh, with that hook. Oh, bro, I got to do that next week. We got to talk about that next week. I love how you bring that hook. Yeah, that movement is beautiful, my brother. But always working on refining. And then you don't always have to end with the threes and the fours. You can be bladed on your footwork as well, right? Like that. Right, so instead of always ending like this, you can end like this. Yeah, add that into the arsenal. Beautiful. All right, everybody take a look at Kuya Jonathan. Keep going. Everybody take a break. Kuya Jonathan just came in, but let's take a look at his movement. Drayon. Let's take a look at Kuya John right here. Pin him up. Okay. Excellent. So again, staying out of the center line, right? Kuya Jonathan is staying out of the center line, regardless if the ball is coming to the left or to the right, right? Always checking the ball with one side of the stick or the other, right? I love that switching. I saw Mateo doing that switching, and that's how you start cleaning up, right? Use the butt of the stick to also aim. It doesn't have to be just the medium. Excellent. But that's what we want. We want you continually flowing with the ball while maintaining your own flow, and at the same time, aiming for your accuracy, right? Once in a while, that's probably the only time you can square up when you do that, what he just did, when you square up and have the ball touch the center of the stick, right? Even though when you do the cross, do that cross block again, Kuya Jonathan? That one right there, you see, it was still at the tip. It wasn't squared up. Beautiful movement. All right. Thank you, everybody. Good job. Let's close out. Kuya Jonathan, great movement. We'll do a quick one sentence or one word reflection about class today. We'd like to go on around the room, but if there's something more in a sentence, you can. I just want to honor everybody's time. Thank you so much for working out today. It's great to have everybody come see everybody's movement and see everybody's refinement. It's really, really nice to see what people are doing their homework, because you could tell, right? There's no other honesty than your movement, your actions, right? Everybody can always say that I'm this, I'm that, but your action speaks louder, and your actions have definitely spoke today, because it shows that you've been training, you've been embodying it, you've been thinking about it. So I really appreciate you. So that's my share, my one sentence, hella long, but I'd like to pass it over to the next person. Kuya Jonathan, I'm going to choose you next. If you could just, again, you could continue to come train with me. I'll be here till 12. But any kind of quick reflection, any aha moments, acknowledgement, appreciation, or I forget the other A, but any of those A's. I think you're muted, bro. Thank you.
Yeah, just blessed to be able to jump into class. Really dope to always be able to see your movement, everyone's movement. I was like, fudge, I missed what was the interaction between what was happening between you and Trisha. I was like, fudge, I don't know where I'm at.
Oh, what was it?
It was when you came out
Oh, yeah, it's cool. We got that recorded. So you come watch the video later.
Oh, hell yeah. Okay, I'm in.
Yes. Yeah.
But yeah, it's blessed, honored to be here. We got plenty of work to do. So
thank you for being here, Queer Jonathan. Remember, you guys are always welcome. I don't care if you care to come the last minute, but I'm glad you just come and support and worked out with us. Yeah, anything else?
No, that's it.
Queer John, can you choose the next person? And then again, I'm going to be here for another till 12, so if you want to train afterwards.
Let's do it. Pierre.
Pierre?
I'm tired today.
Tired today. You still move very beautifully.
So the concentration as is down.
Yeah.
But nice. I like always more.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much, Pierre. You looked amazing. Yeah, thank you for sharing and being here with us today. Choose the next person, Pierre.
Excuse me. Trish.
Trish.
Hey. So, my thoughts were: I wish I had spent more time on the homework.
Oh, you got muted. Simple,
I just wish I spent more time with the homework with a simple like Corto and then thing, because that's the whole setup for this new technique that we learned, and I needed to practice it in action. So I just wish I had spent more time on my own time.
Thank you, Trish. You can always do that. I mean, I know it's probably hard for your space. Remember, adjust to the range of the ball, right? So earlier, if you need to step backwards, step backwards, right? So, damn. I mean, I know that's hard. You know, I gave you guys something hard to do, so I apologize. But
oh, I love it. It's like I needed to practice more in my own time to do it.
Okay, yeah, when you can do so, because this is going to be important, because this is you adjusting between medium and short range, right? Now, even hitting the ball, it's like, that's tough, man. Like, I have people that hit me up, that text me and email me, and they're like martial artists for over 25, 30 years. And they're like, Jay, I don't know how many times you guys can hit that ball like that. They're having a hard time because it's practice. The more you spend time doing this, you know, even me, I'm still not accurate 100% of the time. I'm pretty close. But like today, I was not even close to 90. I think today I was close to 85 or something. But that's just you time working out and adjusting. You don't have to hit the ball if you're in crowded space. Maybe stepping backwards, right?
Yes.
That way you can hit it with a tip, because I want the tip, right?
Yeah, that's my big thing, because I kept in, if I did land it, it would be like here rather than.
Right, I saw that.
So it would be more like what you said, stepping out and making my own range. So
yeah. And then
micro adjustments need,
yeah.
I need to process that and make it work.
Totally. And for the medium, so the corto, the short range strikes, it's okay to be tight, right? But for the medium and long strikes, then those strikes, you're a little becoming more open. You're wider, right? So if you're going to do a wider circular strike, then make sure it's a big circle. But now if you got to adjust because it's a short space, then you can still do a circle strike, but make it smaller. Make it smaller instead of a bigger circle, right? So for me, I'm doing a jam. If it's big and it's a wide range, then I'm going bigger, right? But now if I'm going to adjust and I'm closer, then my circle is smaller, right? It's smaller. But I still want to work on accuracy. So if it's landing to where it's the base of your strike, see if you have the space to back up, that way it's the tip. Okay?
So is it accurate to say that you're, when you mean smaller circle, you're still using the full range of the stick, but you're keeping your hand closer to your hip? Like that.
Excellent. Adjusting. Yes. You're adjusting. So it's still a medium. It's a medium strike, maybe even a long range motion, but the target is closer, right? But the motion is the same as a medium. It's the same as a largo, full range strike. But what you're doing, you're shortening it, right? So we're hella urban style. We're hip hop. We're like have to adjust. You know, cool. Any other question, Trish? Excellent. Pass it over to the next person. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mateo.
So I've been always saying that the Pasay is very uncomfortable, but now I think it's starting to become more comfortable. Like the more I do it, and I'm starting to truly enjoy this, and yeah, just practicing it more will help me grow. And I think that's about it. Just becoming more comfortable.
Excellent. Thank you, Mateo. I really appreciate your feedback all the time, especially as someone that's coming in from, you know, a younger generation and how you see it. Again, by me, it's uncomfortable. I want you to keep giving us that critical feedback, Mateo, so I don't want you thinking that it's not okay to say uncomfortable, because totally okay for me, because that makes us, you know, make want to practice more and figure it out. So thank you so much for that. And yeah, I think part of the solution is just playing and practicing, right? So the more you practice, the better, right? So thank you so much for sharing. Mateo, would you like to choose the next person?
Dimitri.
Okay. For first, I wanted to again thank you. It's so amazing. It's very, very nice classes. Very good.
Thank you, my brother.
And I like so much the combination. You know, combination for solo, the corto, medio, largo. I like that. And to open the windows in my head when
Excellent.
I sleep.
Excellent.
It's
yes.
Very nice. I reflect a lot these things. And it's open the windows. It's open the things in my head. It's very
excellent.
Nice.
And I could see it in your movement, Dimitri. You know, like your combos, your ability to switch within the range and stay out of the center line. Yeah. You know, I love it. It's beautiful because it's minute, it's micro, small movements. It's like, it's starting to look like boxing in Muay Thai a little bit. You know, just the way the little micro movements are stepping out. But it's more, but now you're engaging the entire body and you're using the floor. You know, you're not just sticking and being in the center line. You know, so it was beautiful. You guys always get a chance to review the videos and look at everybody's movement. And man, it really, everybody's improvement. So thank you. Who would you like to choose next, Dimitri?
Joyon.
Yo. You know, it's my first time. You know, it is natural. I feel like this is all natural because, you know, coming from boxing to this, it's like simple. It's not too simple, but it's a little different towards like form and like. Keeping my hands up, that come natural, but keeping a stick up, that don't come natural.
Right.
So you gotta like practice it. Y'all motivated me today to get better because I was hearing all the good things y'all was doing. So I was like, no, I gotta be better.
Excellent.
Because I'm always looking at competition. All competition is good competition in my eye. And thank y'all for coming out today.
Excellent. Thank you, Dreon. I appreciate you for being here. Again, Dreon is one of my former high school students and he boxes. So I'm really, I really appreciate him joining us and willing to learn our art, this art form, which is definitely your art form now, Dreon.
Yes,
especially if you show the respect and dedication that you continue to do all your combat arts. But yeah, and part of that too is me adjusting to all of you as an instructor. And because Dreon has that boxing background, then, I'll, you know, just like Akuya, Jonathan has a Muay Thai background, and Dimitri has the Wing Chun, and so is Pierre. You know, we got to, like, be able to adjust and accordingly, right? And be able to fuse all of that, right? Because martial arts is like, you know, everybody has a different roots, but it's all one, right? It's all one. We all know this. So thank you so much for being able to be open to learning something new, but also influencing us to making it more simple. You know, like we got to really also use this and we can't just like beautify the martial part of it and not make it practical. You know, we got to make this shit practical too. So I think that's the other influence that the other combat sports like boxing and Muay Thai brings to it too. So thank you for sharing your piece and joining us on your first day, Dreon. I appreciate you for being here. Would you like to choose the next person who
was there? It's another one? I thought that was everybody.
Oh, is that it?
That's everybody.
Yeah, I think.
Hold on, I haven't gone yet.
Oh, Max. Oh, our grads in 2020.
Yeah, I think Max, the little. I think
the, I didn't know it was another window.
I think the little tease of like the Moro step and the Moro movements
kind of piqued my interest, and I'm kind of looking forward to more integration with, especially with the weapon, of those different like steps and whatnot, because I'm all down for learning and integrating new movements into my play style. And so, yeah.
Excellent, Max. Thank you, Maxwell. And I really appreciate seeing you move, and thank you for sharing. I want to make sure that, are you guys all, because I'm using Facebook groups or Facebook to communicate with everybody, and that's how I share videos. But I usually, like, I'll forward this to Maxwell and Mateo's dad, and he'll forward it to him. And I follow them on IG, but I don't know if there's other ways that I could send you the link. But we made a video about the Moro variation, like the Guru Greg made a recent video about it. But I want you guys to watch it, because that way, because I know Jonathan has watched it, and I know some of y'all, Trish has watched it, but start integrating it into your footwork. So yes, Maxwell, the Moro footwork, the crossing, this one, the backward, and the one this one, right? This one. So these are really important for our particular system, right? That one, and then these two, because this is what's gonna start getting your footwork to start moving in the circles, right? And I think in Chinese martial arts and Bagua, they do a lot of circular movement, right? Here in the Filipino martial arts, it's these movements. In our system, I don't know about other Filipino martial arts systems, but our movement is this circular footwork, when your footwork is starting to do this, right? And this is when you are gonna start to engage spirals and circles. But again, I don't want people thinking they learn our footwork and our movement, they can just start spinning around like dancers. No, we don't want to be spinning when it's not pragmatic, when it's not thoughtful, because you could turn around and someone's gonna punch you in the face and your spin is nothing, right? So what you wanna be able to do is utilize your footwork that you're ready to spiral or circle if you need to, right? So that's why it's important to include the moros, the moro steps, and this crossback step. Because right here, we're already ready, right? We're still looking at our opponent, but we're ready to spiral or go this way. And then when we step this way, when we point the foot out that way, it automatically, Master Sunny would always say, treat your foot like your hands. So when your hands are, and then treat your hands like swords, like blades. So then that also means you treat your feet like blades, right? So that's why I want you, at the beginning of our session, I want you pendulum with the ball, but I also want you to blade in your body. But if I didn't tell you, I want you to also blade your feet. I want you to blade your feet, right? So if you see me playing with the ball, I don't want you to just see me playing with up here. I want you to start seeing how my foot is bladed against the ball. Right? Even if I come at it at different angles, my foot is still bladed towards the ball, right? So even when I do this small little movement, that's like, I'm imagining my foot to be like a blade and I'm angling it, right? So my foot is also bladed. Okay? So using your feet to target your opponent, right? And then raising off the ball of your heel to switch and transfer power. Switch weight. Right? We'll play more with that next week, but those are great things to close out with. Thank you for that, Maxwell.
Damn.
That way you can start. So that way you don't end, you don't get married to this back and forth pendulum.
Right?
Now when you start including these all the time, right? So now at the end of the pendulum, instead of me doing this, now I'm doing this. Right? It's extra. You don't need it, but it's a good training drill So to get you ready to start moving around, okay? Excellent. Thank you so much, Maxwell. I hope that covered people's questions. Are there any last minute questions or aha moments that folks want to share before we leave? Did everybody go? Pierre went, Mateo went. Okay. All right. Okay. So I want to say thank you so much for training with us today. It's been great to see you continue to get better. You know, regardless of being sheltered in place, I think it's important for you to continue to refine yourself, right? Especially while everybody's like, oh, I'm sheltered in place, I'm not going to do nothing. No, you continue to do something to work out, to refine your body and angle and blade it yourself. So I think it's important for you to continue to do this, and I appreciate you. And and as the world gets, hopefully gets better, then you're making yourself sharper, right? Whether the world goes crazier or the world gets better, it's better for you to stay sharper, right?
Now,
it's better for you to continue to work out, to have your mind focused on something else, and have your body ready for battle just in case, right? But of course, we want to wish the positivity and love and justice for everything that's the world is going through. But remember, the only world you have control of is your own internal world, right? So make sure that you're continuing to refine yourself, focus in, calling upon your ancestors when you're training, being aligned with what you feel is right, right? That way to keep yourself healthy mentally and physically, and hopefully spiritually as well, all right? So we're here again next Saturday. I appreciate you training and promoting the culture and the art form of our ancestors and our people. And it's also yours. Please make sure to take care of it, refine it, and also and add your own into it, okay? And make it even better for you, all right? And we're going to do a salute, but I'm going to stick around, play some music, train for anyone that want to stay. For the rest of you, thank you so much for spending time with us. I'm so grateful that you are with us today. I'm going to do a screenshot for attendance. So look cute for a second.
You want to know what I noticed, Jay?
No, Drayon, no, dude, you're not cute. All right, look mean and cute at the same time. Dimitri, your head's being cut by the camera.
There you go. Cool.
Where's your head? There you go. All right, salute. Thank you so much for being here. Wait. All right. And then, all right, here we go. Salute. Thank you so much. Have a good rest of the weekend. I'll see you next Saturday.
Bye. Thank
you. Have fun. I'll be here right now. I'm going to training if you have questions. But thank you so much. Yeah.